Okay, so we've done a little bit of moving stuff around and kept the same equation up before. Remember, our goal is to use quadratic programming to maximize this equation. So let me talk a little bit about the properties of the solution for this equation. So here's the first one. It turns out that once you find the alphas that maximize this equation, you can actually recover the W, which was the whole point of this exercise in the first place.
That's the little W, not the big W.
That's the little W, not the big W. That's right. Okay?
Neat.
Yeah, that is kind of neat. So it's really easy to do. And of course, once you know W, it's easy to recover B. You just find a value of X, you stick it in the W that you know is equal to plus 1, and then poof, you can find out B. So you can recover W directly from this, and you can recover B from in sort of the obvious way. But here's some other properties that are a little bit more interesting for you. So I want you to pay attention to two things. One I'm just going to have to tell you, and the other I want you to think about. So here's the one that I'm going to tell you. It turns out, okay, that alpha, each of those alphas, are mostly zero, usually. So if I told you that in the solution to this, most of the alphas that you come back with are going to be zero, what does that tell you about W?
So W is the sum of the data points times their labels times alpha. And if the alpha is zero, that the corresponding data point isn't really going to come into play in the definition of W at all. So a bunch of the data just don't really factor into W.
That's exactly right. So basically, some of the vectors matter for finding the solution to this, and some do not. So it turns out each of those data points are vectors, but you can find all of the support that you need for finding the optimal W in just using a few of those vectors.
The non-zero alphas.
Yeah, well, the ones with non-zero alphas. So you've basically built a machine that only needs a few support vectors.
Oh. So the data points for which the corresponding alpha is non-zero, those are the support vectors?
Yes, those are the ones that provide all the support for W. So knowing that W is the sum over a lot of these different data points and their labels and the corresponding alphas, and that most of those are zeros, that implies that only a few of the X's matter. Now, Michael, let me do a quick quiz.
Yay.